G'day and welcome to Black Opal Direct. My name's Justin. Today we're talking about types of Australian opal.
What is the best?
All right, so we're going to talk about four main types of the best opal in the world. And first is black opal, then crystal opal, boulder opal, and then white opal. Now the first type of opal I want to talk about is black opal, and black opal is the most valuable opal on the planet, and the reason is, there's a few reasons. One reason is it only 95% of it comes from one small place in Australia called Lightning Ridge, and the other reason is because of its dark body tone. Not many other types of opal in the world naturally form a dark body tone. Now, it gets this dark body tone from the knobby or the seam structure that it's made up of, and it has usually a dark backing. So you get a piece of knobby like this and a colour bar runs right through it. The idea is to make sure that darkness on the back stays underneath the colour, so that when you have a stone, you have potch on the back and colour on the top, and that's what makes a black opal. And here's a really great example. I have a crystal opal here, and the crystal opal, you can see straight through it. Now the colours are okay, they're quite still a quite nice stone, but if I was to blacken the back of this stone by colouring it in, so let's just colour the back in, it will give the same effect as a black opal. And I'm not saying to do this because then it becomes a doublet opal, but if you find this naturally formed with black potch on the back, you will see that a light opal can become a black opal very easily if it's formed naturally with potch on it. So check out that. The colours really kick out a lot more now. So that's what makes a black opal. So the next gemstone is a crystal opal, and a crystal opal is found in most of the opal fields in Australia. A little bit more common than a black opal, unless you get an absolute top gem crystal, which is almost or just as rare as a good black opal. And this is a good example right here of a top gem crystal opal. But the characteristics of a crystal opal is that you can see through it, or if you shine a light behind it, the light will travel through the stone. And that's what you consider a crystal opal. Now, crystal opal, because it's clearer, you can see more depth into the stone. So if there's colour flakes on the top and there's colour flakes underneath the stone, you'll see more of a 3D or three-dimensional look to the stone. So crystal opal is still a very, very beautiful type of opal. So the next type of opal is a white opal, and white opal can be confused with crystal opals. A lot of people will call a white opal a crystal opal because you can shine a torch and the light will still go through. But the difference is that with a white opal, it has a milky tinge through it. So it's not so crystally, as in you think of a crystal and you think of something that's cloudy. Well, a white opal is a little bit more cloudy. It still can have beautiful colour, but the whole body tone or the whole aspect or look of the stone is very white and milky. And that's what makes a white opal. So the last type of opal that's formed in Australia is an opal called boulder opal. And it's found in brown ironstone host rock. And when you have veins of colour going through, it can be pretty thin and not look like much, but you can split these little veins and they can show colour inside them. So this is a type of opal that is quite difficult to cut and takes a lot of experience, but can be just as beautiful as black opal and just as valuable. And you don't so much get the potch that you do in Lightning Ridge, but you will get the ironstone. And when this ironstone is dark enough to make the body tone of this opal dark enough, it is also considered black opal. So they're the main types of opal from Australia. Now there is one find that has just been recently found in Western Australia, and it's a type of opal that has no color play, but it does have a tint. So this is like Mexican fire opal, where you can see that it's not clear like a diamond, but it does have a tint of yellow to orange. And this find is a new find that we're not 100% sure about yet, what it's going to do, or whether it's actually going to show some color play down in the future. But it is a nice type of gemstone. It's a volcanic opal. All the rest of the opals in Australia are sedimentary, besides one little place called Tintinbar, which nobody mines anymore. But this is a volcanic opal and seems to be very stable. So that is one opal to look out for in the future from Australia. And that's about it. Thanks for watching. I hope I've cleared up the opal types, and I'll see you next time.